Good afternoon, everyone. I can understand some people will have few concerns about the test. So we'll use today's lecture to understand everything that's going to happen in the test. Right? I just want to do one question today because that is a part of the test. Then I'll explain to you all the portion, how to attempt the test, what exactly to study, what to do if you all have doubts. Okay, so we'll be discussing all those things today. Let me just finish one last part of the, that might be there for the test. Okay, that is finite and infinite. See, in the group I've put that the portion is still worksheet 4, but the only thing that can come from worksheet 5 is finite and infinite might come because it's very simple. So I've included it. So make sure you all know what is a finite set and infinite set. So what I'll do is, since it's a part of the test, I'll just revise it right now. There are around 7 sums based on that. We'll discuss that. I'll pick one of you all. You all can help me out. And then we'll come back to the test. And if you all have doubts, we can discuss that. Okay? Okay. Let me explain to you all what is a finite set. I think last time we had already discussed it. Finite set is when we can count how many elements are there in the set. For example, if A is equal to 1, 2, 3. And if I ask anyone how many elements are there in this, they can count and tell me there are 3 elements. If you can count, counting means it can even go till 1000. Like if I have a set like this, 1, 2, 3, dot, dot, dot. But then they put 999, 1000. They have not put all the numbers here, but still, if I ask you to write, you will take a lot of time, but after writing, you can count them. No, we know that there are 1000 elements in this. So even this is finite. Infinite is when we cannot count only. Infinite set. For example, if I write C and I just write 1, 2, 3 and then I put dot, 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 I don't end it. So here, since it's not ending, I will not know where to stop. And if I don't know where to stop, I cannot count it only. Right? So that is why this is an infinite set. So it need not be numbers. It can be anything that you cannot count that becomes infinite set. Okay? So I hope you all have the worksheet with you all. I'll be picking one of you all and I'll be discussing which ones are finite and which ones are infinite. That's all you need to know now. Okay. Let me pick Aishwarya from Ghatkopar. Hello, Aishwarya. Hello. What happened to Aishwarya? Okay, let me try Sarvesh from Ghatkopar. Hello, Sarvesh.
Hello, sir.
You can hear me?
Yes, sir.
What I'll do is I'll keep giving you examples. You have to tell me whether they are finite or infinite, okay?
Okay, sir.
For example, do you have the worksheet with you right now?
No, sir.
Okay, I'll write the question down. The first sum is this. Can you read this, Sarvesh?
Yes, sir. A is a set.
Set of
all x such that x is greater than 10.
No, x is less than 10.
N is greater than x. X belongs to numbers.
What numbers are n?
Natural numbers.
Natural numbers. And again, I think I heard you say 10 is greater than x. You should always say from point of view of x. So you should always say x is less than 10. Or agar aisa rahega, then you should say x is greater than x ke hisab se bolne ka. Theek hai?
Yes.
Okay. Now they are telling you that x are natural numbers and yes. x is less than 10. So can you tell me less than 10, which all natural numbers are there? I'll write it down for you.
1.
1.
2.
2.
3.
Hmm?
4. 5. 6. 7. 8. 9.
And?
Yes.
Was it 9?
Yes.
Okay. Now tell me in this, can you count these or you cannot count?
Count this.
So is it a finite set or infinite?
Finite set.
Very good. So A finite. Test mein sasam aayega to kar paoge na?
Yes.
Haan, Sarvesh, you'll be able to do such a sum?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Haan, okay. Tanish is asking some question. Just wait, I'll be answering all the questions. Let me just finish these 7 sums. Achha, second pe aa jate hain. I'm writing the question again. Okay, read this.
B is...
Sarvesh?
Yes, sir. B is set of B is set of all y such that y is smaller than minus 1 and y belongs to integer.
Very good. Now tell me, agar mujhe b likhna hai, smaller than minus 1, kaun kaun sa integer aayega?
Smaller than minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, dot dot dot.
मतलब ये रुक नहीं रहा है
नहीं
तो कैन यू काउंट दिस और यू कैन नॉट काउंट इट
इनफाइनाइट सेट सर
इनफाइनाइट सेट बिकॉज़ इट विल नेवर स्टॉप सो वी कांट काउंट सो आई विल राइट बी इज इनफाइनाइट सेट यू अंडरस्टूड दिस सर्वेश
यस सर
अच्छा एक लास्ट वाला पूछता हूँ थर्ड द क्वेश्चन इज सी इज अ सेट ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 9 फ्रॉम योर स्कूल आपके स्कूल में है ना सारे क्लास 9 मतलब स्टैंडर्ड 9 वाले बच्चे लोग विल कम इन सेट सी
ओके
सो टेल मी कैन यू काउंट ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 9 फ्रॉम योर स्कूल
यस इफ वी हैव
हाँ मतलब अगर लॉकडाउन खुल जाएगा एंड आई आस्क यू टू गेट द लिस्ट ऑफ ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 9 फ्रॉम योर स्कूल पॉसिबल रहेगा आपको
नहीं
आप नहीं काउंट कर लिस्ट नहीं लेके आ पाओगे क्या कितने बच्चे लोग हैं आपके स्टैंडर्ड में आपके स्कूल में स्टैंडर्ड 9th में
हाँ इफ अगर पर्टिकुलर डेटा होगा तो लेके आ सकते हैं
हाँ तो आपका अच्छा इन योर स्टैंडर्ड हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट्स आर देयर यू कैन काउंट दैट नो
यस यस
सो दैट इज फाइनाइट सेट और इनफाइनाइट
फाइनाइट सेट सर
ओके सो आई डोंट हैव टू मेक अ लिस्ट बिकॉज हर एक बच्चों का अलग अलग ये आएगा But here I can say it is finite set. ठीक है?
Yes.
Okay, let's move on to the fourth one. Okay, thank you, Sarvesh. I'll pick someone else now.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Let me try Jitesh Pawar from Saidham. Hello, Jitesh. Hello, Jitesh. Hello. Jitesh is not listening to the lecture, I think. Fine. Let me try Royce.
Hello.
Hello, Roy. Hello, you can hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Ah, okay. We'll continue with the examples of finite and infinite. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Royce is the right way to pronounce it, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So when I'm looking at the fourth question, It says a set of people from your village. So if you're from a particular village, okay, can you count how many people are there in your village?
Yes, sir.
So is that a finite set or an infinite set?
Yes, sir. It is a finite set, sir.
So fourth is a finite set, right? They have not given a name for that set. So I can say the given set is a finite set. Okay. Let's go for the fifth one. The fifth one is set of apparatus in your laboratory.
So it will be a finite
set.
Count
what all, how many things are there in your, yes, because we can easily count it, no? That will also be a finite set. Okay. Sixth one is a set of whole numbers. Tell me whole numbers. What all numbers are there in whole numbers?
0, 1, 2, 3, and it goes on.
So can we count it?
Yes, sir. No, sir, you can't count it.
You can count
because it's infinite, so it will be an infinite set.
Very good, infinite set. And the last one, seventh sum, set of rational numbers. Can you tell me rational numbers will be finite or infinite?
It will be infinite, sir, because there's no limit to it. So,
very good. Achha, one thing I'll like to tell everyone is, rational numbers, we cannot write it in roster form. Right? Rational numbers, we cannot make a list because there's no beginning, there is no end to rational numbers. There's no, we don't know where to start from. Any fraction, any integer upon integer will come. But where do we start from? Yeah, 5 upon 4, next rational number, nobody knows. So that is why we cannot write it in, so we cannot write it in roster form. So all you'll have to do is, you'll have to just write rational numbers, the set of rational numbers is an infinite set. Okay, Royce, thank you.
Yes, sir. Welcome, sir.
Okay, fine. So I think technically you're done with a portion of the test. Now, let me just clarify what all portion is there for the test. Okay. Firstly, if I tell you all the portion, we started with real numbers. And maybe some people have bought the textbooks and all now. But if I want to tell you all the exercise wise, you have done 2.1 from your exercise in real numbers and 2.5. And from sets, you have done 1.1. Okay, so this is the portion that we had done. But rather than following the textbook, I would suggest, because when I've created the test paper, I've made it from the worksheets. So worksheet has these sums, plus it has extra sums. So if you want to practice those worksheets. So all the sums from worksheet 1 to worksheet 4 will come. And from worksheet 5, the only thing that you should know is what are finite and infinite set. Isse aur kuch nahi aayega aapke test mein. So I think we discussed finite infinite already, so I hope it is clear to everyone, right? Okay, another thing that I'd like to tell you all about the test is the first 5 sums are going to be MCQs. MCQs means there'll be a question and there'll be 4 options, A, B, C, D. Have we seen Kaun Banega Crorepati? So what you have to do is, when you'll write the answer, you don't need to show the steps in MCQs. You don't need to show the working, nothing. Only you have to write the answer, right? Now, when you write the answer, imagine the first sum may, let us say the answer is option B and option D is natural numbers. So there are many, I've seen many people just write B to show that option B, or they just write natural numbers. So, sirf option B likhoge ya sirf answer likhoge nahi chalega. Theek hai? These both are the wrong way to show your MCQs. So, I've followed the format of board, how we do it in board exams, because board exam also has MCQs. So, I want you to write it, let us say option B hai and answer is natural numbers. So, you'll write it like this. Option B. So you've told which option it is. And uske aage you'll write the answer also. If the answer is natural numbers, you'll write it like this. Natural numbers. Theek hai? If you all know this much, sorry, if you all follow this step and you all only know your MCQs, out of 20, you all can easily score 5 marks. That means, agar aapko 5 mark lana hai, aapko koi sums, kuch bhi nahi aayega, to bhi chalega. You should know the basics properly. If you have understood all the concepts and you all can answer, that is enough. Okay? Agar aap sums puchoge, if I go lecture by lecture, in the first lecture, we had discussed what are natural numbers, what are whole numbers, what are all those videos you'll easily be able to find on YouTube. So you all can go and check it out again. And after that, we discussed sums like where we convert fraction. Like 5 upon 4. We came to know how to identify whether it is a recurring number or a terminator. Yeah, I had explained to you all ki if the denominator has 2s or 5s, a denominator mein 2 ya 5 hota hai, then it will be terminating. Agar 2 or 5 ko chhod ke kuch aur hota hai, then it will be recurring. Then you all might remember we had discussed how to convert of decimals to fraction, that recurring decimal, how to convert it to fraction. We discussed mod related sums. We have discussed roster form. Ye sab aap go through karo. Aur ye sari doubts hum log Saturday discuss karne wale hain afternoon mein. I'll confirm the timing, but mostly the timing that we'll fix will be 12, I think. Maybe 12 to 1, 1:30, because our test is 6 baje hone wala hai. So you'll have entire day tomorrow to work on this. I hope you have already started after the test was announced. You have already started practicing. And there might be students who might have joined maybe after first lecture, after second lecture, maybe must have missed the lecture. Unke liye hum log ne sare videos upload karke rakhe. Go through that once. So that what happens is, jab hum log doubt solving rakhenge, ab log sab sums wapas puchoge to pura din doubts mein nikal jayega. Usse acha prepare karke aao, to doubts bahut easily solve ho jaye. Theek hai? So today also, what I'll do is, I'll be going through the chats right now. If there are any questions, I'll be answering that. If there are doubts, I'll try to clear as many as possible today. Aur jo aaj bach jayega, wo hum log baad mein kar lenge. What I would suggest is, if people have doubts, they can keep their hands raised. मैं ये करके गो थ्रू करूंगा. ओके, आई एम गोइंग थ्रू द चैट्स राइट नाउ एंड वट एवर क्वेश्चन आई फील आई कैन आंसर आई ट्राई दैट. ओके, सम पीपल आर आस्किंग सर्ड्स है क्या. आई हैव इन माय वर्कशीट आई हैव नॉट डन इवन वन सम ऑफ सर्ड्स, सो सर्ड्स इज नॉट देयर. सम पीपल आर आस्किंग पोर्शन अगेन. आई हैव एक्सप्लेन द पोर्शन. Portion is from worksheet 1 till worksheet 4, and fifth worksheet mein se sirf finite infinite aayega. Do we have to write the sentence in MCQ, the question? No, only thing in MCQ you have to write is this much. Option B, natural numbers. Itna hi likhna hai aapko. Roster form hai. Roster form is the listing method. You can show rough work, that is not required to get full marks. Agar aapne rough work nahi dikhaya to bhi chalega. Worksheet solution of 3, 4, 5 are not given. If you all require it, I'll send it. But 5 is not done yet. And 4 ka I have done every sum in class. So 4th I won't be sending the solution. 3 ka I can send the solutions. Some people are asking how much marks is there for the test. That's 20 marks the test hai. Mean sums, I don't know what are mean sums. Yashika Pujari, what do you mean by mean sums? Okay, some person was asking a doubt about list of students. Wo maine 9th standard ke students ka pucha tha. You don't have to make the list. Question was just tell whether it's finite or infinite. So aapko sirf batana hai finite hai ya infinite. Right? Some people want to do mods. Yes. Dekho, what I would suggest is, rather than telling me teach mod or teach this, specific mujhe batao ki from worksheet 3 you want to do this sum. अगर आप ऐसे करोगे ना, जैसे someone is telling me worksheet 3 question 2 का first sum, then I'll explain that. तो जब Saturday doubt solving रहेगा, ऐसे ही doubts डालना. अगर आप लोग बोलोगे मेरे को ये type के sum सिखा दो, then I will not be able to help you because it takes a lot of time. If someone does not have the worksheet, if they join late, contact your branch head, they'll forward you all the 5 worksheets. Okay. Someone is asking, exam mein kya hoga? Exam mein, I've explained to you all the portion, real number and sets. Worksheet 1 se 4 tak aapko karna hai. Achha, one doubt I can see is if 0.6 bar ka question hai. Let me just explain it here. It's a small doubt. 0.6 bar comes out to be 6 upon 9. So they're asking whether we should leave it or we should cancel. If you can cancel, always cancel. Okay, agar aapne 6 upon 9 chhod di aur answer ye hai, to aapke marks katenge. So make sure to follow that. Yes, just give me a second. I'll keep all my worksheets open so that in case aapko koi doubt hai, then I can clear it. अच्छा, बिफोर आई गेट इन टू सम्स, और कोई भी पेपर रिलेटेड डाउट है तो पहले वो आप लोग पूछ लो, फिर मैं सम्स पे आता हूँ. समवन इज आस्किंग व्हेदर सेट बिल्डर मेथड इज देयर. नो, सेट बिल्डर मेथड इज नॉट देयर, आई हैव नॉट थॉट इट. शशिकांत सर हैड गॉन थ्रू इट इन द डेमो, बट आई एम नॉट काउंटिंग दैट बिकॉज आई हैव नॉट डन अ लॉट ऑफ सम्स ऑफ दैट टाइप. समवन इज आस्किंग सोलर मंथ्स लर्न करना पड़ेगा. यस, बहुत ज्यादा चांस है कि सोलर मंथ वाला सम आ जाए टेस्ट में, क्योंकि वो सबका फेवरेट रहता है. अगर मेरे टेस्ट में नहीं आएगा तो स्कूल के टेस्ट में आएगा, स्कूल के टेस्ट में नहीं आएगा तो मेरे टेस्ट, कहीं कोई ना कोई टेस्ट में तो आने वाला है, तो बाय हार्ट करके रखना. हाँ, समवन इज आस्किंग फाइनाइट इनफाइनाइट सेट में कैन वी जस्ट राइट द सेट इज अ फाइनाइट सेट. यस, यू कैन डू दैट, जस्ट राइट द सेट इज अ फाइनाइट सेट. टाइमिंग ऑफ द टेस्ट इज 6 o'clock. Tanish from Ghatkopar, I forgot your doubt. Can you just message your doubt again? Acha, ek second na. Someone is asking, subah 6 ko nahi, sham ko 6 ko rahega. It will not be at 6 a.m., it will be at 6 p.m. I'm sorry, I didn't make that clear. A lot of doubts are coming. Students are asking Venn diagram hai. Nahin, nothing that was explained in the demo is there. Sums will only come from the worksheet. So, agar worksheet mein Venn diagram nahin sikhaya, toh nahin aayega. Agar set builder nahin sikhaya, toh nahin aayega. Theek hai? In singleton, acha, one doubt that one student is asking is, can they directly write singleton or empty set? Agar if it is a set builder form, then convert it to roster and then say whether it is singleton or empty set. Direct mat likhna. Theek hai? To always make sure agar singleton ya empty set hai, write it in roster form, then make it then answer whether it is singleton or empty. Yes, I had only explained it to you all last time, how to scan paper and everything, and I told you all the test paper will come at 5:50. So it will come at 5:50. So you'll get enough reading time. Acha, one concept wala doubt aa raha hai jo maine abhi sikhaya tha. Bachcha bol raha hai ki we have said population in a village is a finite set. So population vary karte rahega alag alag villages mein. So ye finite set kaise hai? Ye question aate rahega. I'll explain it like this. देखो, the question says in a particular village, ठीक है, अगर मैं एक particular village का बात करता हूं तो वो village का population कुछ रहेगा एक time पे. जैसे आज का today at the end of the day, if I ask you to count how many children, what was the population of that place, then you can easily count it, right? Population does not keep varying, it will keep increasing. तो अगर मैं पूछता हूँ आज रात को 12 बजे तक पॉपुलेशन क्या है, तो आप लोग बता सकते हो ना कितना रहेगा? यू विल नॉट काउंट एनी चाइल्ड हु इज बॉर्न आफ्टर 12 o'clock. तो व्हेन दे से पॉपुलेशन, जैसे इफ आई आस्क यू इंडिया का पॉपुलेशन क्या है, देन इट इज अ फिक्स्ड नंबर विच विल कीप इंक्रीजिंग बाय टाइम. सो दैट इज व्हाई इट्स अ फाइनाइट सेट, इट इज नॉट अनकाउंटेबल. Continuing with this, Arya Fadnavis has sent me, you have sent me a set builder sum. I have not explained it, so it's not required now. Test is on Saturday at 6 p.m. Finite infinite will be a part of the test, yes. Because it was very simple, we just discussed it today. The test is of 20 marks and it's for 1 hour. Tanish, I'm not sure if I've cleared your doubt because there are many messages coming. Okay. Sampreet is asking one question. Worksheet 1 ka sum number 9. Let me just check that. division. डिविजन आप करके देख लो क्या इशू आ रहा है. एंड इट्स 17/8. सी आई हैड एक्सप्लेन्ड टू यू ऑल अ ट्रिक, बट इवन इफ यू डोंट यूज द ट्रिक एंड यू डिवाइड इट लाइक 17/8, आप करके देख लो कि कितना आता है. ठीक है, डिविजन इज वेरी सिंपल. यू आर इन 9th राइट नाउ. स्टिल इफ यू स्टिल हैव अ डाउट आफ्टर ट्राइंग इट नो, देन व्हाट यू डू इज I'll give you all a simple way of getting your doubts done. देखो अभी तुम लोग जब चैट्स में भेजते रहोगे क्या होगा कि चैट जैसे बहुत जन चैट्स भेज रहे हैं ऊपर ऊपर जाते जाएगा. I might miss a few messages. So what I'll rather tell you all is कि if you all have any doubts, no, send it to your branch head and they'll forward it to me. तो जब मैं सैटरडे को आऊंगा तब मेरे पास एक लिस्ट रहेगा कि यही डाउट्स मुझे करने हैं. Right? And do not keep doubts for the last minute. Genius in whole world is not a set only, so it cannot be finite or infinite. Okay, wait. There is worksheet 3 ka doubt hai. Worksheet 3, sum number 9. Is that find the value of 9? What does that mean? Wait. Kavya, I have not understood your question. Worksheet 3 ka find the value of 9 kahan pe? Just be clear with what sum you're asking. Whether it is a question. Wahan pe do question hai. Find the value. Acha, 9 sum of find the value, right? Okay, understood. Let me just explain that. किसी ने मुझे मॉड वापस एक्सप्लेन करने बोला था, तो ट्राई करो यहां से समझ लेने को. I'm assuming this is your question. This is find the value का 9th sum. Okay, mod basically means जब आप mod हटाते हो किसी में से, उसका साइन पॉजिटिव ही रहेगा. जैसे प्लस 9 का मॉड इज प्लस 9 होगी, माइनस 9 का भी मॉड माइनस 9 नहीं प्लस 9 ही रहेगा. राइट, सो 9 का मॉड इज 9, माइनस 9 का मॉड इज 9, बीच में प्लस था, 9 प्लस 9 इज 18. दिस इज योर आंसर. राइट, आई होप योर डाउट इज क्लियर देयर. वर्कशीट 3 क्वेश्चन 2 का लास्ट सम. Okay, I'll explain that also. Since you're on mod right now, I think we should be able to discuss mod related sums now. Okay, so this is the question, the last sum. So, hopefully, revision ho jaye aap logon ka. मैंने आपको बोला था जब भी मॉड में x रहता है, जैसे यहाँ पे x नहीं था तो यहाँ पे सीधा मैं मॉड हटा सकता हूँ, बट मॉड में जब x होता है और सामने देयर इज अ नंबर, आई हैव टू रिमूव मॉड टू फाइंड x, यू हैव टू फाइंड x ओवर हियर. तो जब मैं मॉड हटाता हूँ, आई विल राइट इट एज 5 + x / 4, मॉड हट गया है, सामने प्लस माइनस आता है. व्हेनेवर यू रिमूव अ मॉड फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट, सामने प्लस माइनस आएगा. Then we separate it as 5 + x / 4 = 5 or 5 + x / 4 = -5, right? 5 right में जाएगा तो x / 4 = 5 - 5, so it becomes x / 4 = 0, 5 - 5 = 0. 4 वहां पे जाके multiply होगा तो x = 0 × 4. x = 0, ये एक आंसर हो गया. दूसरे में, when I take 5 there, I'll get x / 4 = -5, और ये 5 उधर गया तो वो भी -5 हो जाएगा. दोनों -, मतलब we'll add, so it'll become -10. Then I'll take 4 there and multiply, so I'll get x = -10 × 4, so x = -40. राइट, दीज आर द टू आंसर्स. फाइनल इसमें सोल्यूशन लिख देना, द एक्स का वैल्यू इज 4 और -40. ओके, समवन इज आस्किंग फॉर एक्स इज अ प्राइम डिवाइजर ऑफ 120. संप्रीत हैज बीन आस्किंग दिस डाउट फॉर सम टाइम, सो लेट मी जस्ट क्लैरिफाई दैट. प्राइम डिवाइजर ऑफ 120, प्राइम डिवाइजर के लिए क्या करो, what you can do is 120, I hope you all know how to factorize. If I factorize 120, so 2 se jayega 60. One second. Hello. Yeah, sorry, I think I had muted myself. Yeah, I'll just explain that part again. 120 ka 2 se divide karke 60 aata hai. Phir 2 se divide karke 30, 2 se divide karke 15, 3 se divide karke 5. 5 ones are. These are all the, these are called prime factors. Okay. Now when I write the set inside, I will not repeat 2-3 times inside. 2 ek hi baar aayega. There is no repetition allowed. 3 ek baar aayega aur 5 ek baar aayega. Right, Sampreet, I hope you understood this. Okay, continuing. Harshit Patel has some weird doubt. worksheet 4, question 2 ka 5. Okay, let me just check. I hope mod part is now clear to you all. Question 2 ka 5th sum. Okay. No, when you are determining whether it is terminating and non-terminating, you don't have to divide and show. You just have to check whether factors are 2 and 5 or not. So division karke answer mat likhna. Just check whether it is terminating or non-terminating. Only answer is enough. Okay, this is worksheet 4 ka question 2 ka 5th one. The question is this. Now, in general, whenever you have a sum where there is an equation given, aisa equation diya rehta hai na, what you do is just take the equation separately and solve it. Kyunki b ke andar sirf x aa sakta hai aur yahan pe equation mein x square hai. So x square hatane ke liye what you can do is you can take square root on both sides. Square root lene se kya ho jata hai? Square aur root cancel hoke sirf x bachta hai. And square root of everyone knows is just zero. अगर देखो एक ही वैल्यू आ रहा है तो b के अंदर सिर्फ जीरो आएगा and zero is one element. So that is why the answer for this was singleton set. Worksheet number 4, question 2, last sum. That is also similar. Okay. The question is this. Worksheet 4, last sum. Okay. They're telling us x are natural numbers. X ke saamne mein sare natural numbers likh deta. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right? And they're telling us x square kaisa hona chahiye? X square, मैं x square का भी list बना देता हूँ. X square 1 का square 1 होता है, 2 का square 4 होता है, 3 का square 9 होता है, 4 का square 16, 5 का square 25 and so on. But वो लोग ने क्या बोला है? X natural numbers है, मतलब x यहाँ से आने वाला है. But हम लोग को pick कैसा करना है? Our x square should be equal to 0 or less than 0. Either square 0 होना चाहिए, या square 0 से कम, मतलब negative होना चाहिए. तो check करो. इधर पूरे list में कहीं भी 0 है क्या? नहीं है. कोई नेगेटिव है? नेगेटिव भी नहीं है. तो एक्स का कोई भी आंसर नहीं आएगा बिकॉज एक्स स्क्वायर अगर आप देखते हो इट इज नॉट सैटिस्फाइंग दिस कंडीशन. सो सिंस नथिंग विल कम इनसाइड डी दैट्स व्हाई डी बिकम्स एन एम्प्टी सेट. राइट. So, help only for 4 minutes because then we'll have to stop the session. Next lecture aa jayega. But as I said, on Saturday we'll be discussing a lot of doubts. Again, don't. Huh, someone is asking equal sets. I'm not putting in the paper because it can get confusing. So it's not. But finite, infinite from worksheet 3 hai. Okay, equal sets I'm not putting in the paper. Okay, worksheet 3. Someone wants me to help in second last sum. Eight minus x upon 2, that one, right? Okay, I'll just do that quickly. 8 minus x upon 2 is equal to 5. Mod hatayenge to 8 minus x whole upon 2 is equal to plus minus 5. Right? If I separate it, 8 minus x upon 2 is equal to 5 or 8 minus x upon 2 is equal to minus 5. I hope this much part everyone has understood. Ye wala step har ek sum mein same rata hai, aise type ka. Next, we can take 2 there. So 2 5 is at 10, so I'll get 8 minus x is equal to 10. एट उधर जाएगा तो माइनस एक्स इधर बचेगा. बहुत जन गलती से माइनस एक्स को एक्स लिख देते हैं. यू ऑल मेक श्योर माइनस एक्स ही लिखो. टेन माइनस एट आता है. I'll get minus x is equal to 10 minus 8 is 2. So x ka value will be minus 2. Agar minus x is equal to 2 hai, so x ka value minus 2 hoga. And here same, 2 will multiply. So I'll get 8 minus x is equal to minus 10. Again 8 udhar jayega, so minus x is equal to minus 10 minus 8 hoga. Minus x is equal to, dono ko add karenge, to minus 18 aayega, minus minus cut. तो x का वैल्यू 18 हो जाता है. तो आइदर x इज माइनस 2 और x इज 18, राइट? यस. सो व्हाट आई विल डू राइट नाउ इज आई विल स्टॉप विद टुडे सेशन. ओके, वन लास्ट सम वी विल डू, वर्कशीट फॉर सम नंबर 8, एंड देन आई विल स्टॉप फॉर टुडे. एंड एज आई सेड, सैटरडे कल का पूरा दिन है आपके पास. Go through all the worksheets. Keep your doubts ready. What I'll do next time is, if you all send me all your doubts in advance, then worksheet 1 se leke worksheet 4 mein sequence mein jaunga. Okay, worksheet 4, sum number 8 from which question? Question 1 or question 2, Susan? Because question 2 ka sum number 8 I just now did. Janvish, I don't know the meaning of steps, symbol, offsets. Which symbols are you talking about? What you do is send me the symbols ka photos on the WhatsApp that I'll explain it to you on Saturday. Ah, okay, Susan, from question 1. Okay, so today's last sum I'll explain is question 1, sum number 8 from worksheet 4. Okay. The question says x belongs to integer and x square is less than 10. I'll do the same thing again. I had made that list here. ठीक है? मुझे ऐसा d बनाना है. And see, the question says d is a set of all x. मतलब all x इसको क्यों बोलते हैं? Because d के अंदर सिर्फ x के values आएंगे. मतलब only these values will come. But you have to look at x square. X square dekh ke x banana. So this is the list we are following. They are telling us x belongs to integer. Achha, toh ye list follow nahi kar payenge. So I'll just make a new list right now. They are telling us x belongs to integer. So integer can be minus 1, 1. Wait, I'll write it in order. Each mein 0 aata hai. Aage 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Each mein minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. And this is not shopping, it will go on. Okay? Now they are telling us we need the squares to be less than 10. Toh niche mein x square likh raha hun. I'll start from between. We are looking at x square. So 0 ka square is 0, 1 ka square is 1, 2 ka square 4, 3 ka square 9, 4 ka square 16, 5 ka square 25, and so on. Negative mein bhi same hota hai. Minus 1 ka square is 1, not minus 1. Because see, minus 1 into minus 1, when you multiply, minus into minus will become plus, and 1 into 1 is 1. So we have to know that negative ka square is also positive. So minus 1 square is 1, minus 2 square is 4. Minus 3 square is 9, minus 4 square is 16, minus 5 square is 25, and so on. So, Susan, you have to pick up such numbers jinka square is less than 10. Can you see over here? Square less than 10 matlab 0 chalega, 1 chalega, 4 chalega, 9 chalega. This 16 will not work because it's more than 10. 25 will not work. Here also, 1 chalega, 4 chalega, 9 chalega. 16 will not work, 25. Obviously, after that also it will be more than 10. तो x square ये सारे चलेंगे, but again as I said, d is a set of all x. You only have to write answer of x. X square का आंसर नहीं लिखना. तो in d when we write it, look at it. 9 का corresponding x is minus 3, so I'll write minus 3. 4 का is minus 2. have to write the values of x. 1 ka is minus 1. 0 ka is 0. 1 ka is 1. 4 ka is 2. And 9 ka is 3. This should be your answer. Right? I hope, Susan, it's clear what was explained. Trust me, if you all go through the worksheets properly, you all should be able to understand this. And as I said again, I'll be going through the doubts again on Saturday, mostly at 12, right? I'll confirm by tomorrow what the timing is. The test, again, I'm repeating, the test is at 6 p.m. on Saturday. Doubt will be on Saturday, but at 12. So use your time well tomorrow. Understand everything of the worksheet. Right? All the best for the test. Steps-wise working you have to show, obviously. As in this working, you don't have to show. In roster form, only if equation is there, working is required. Otherwise, working is not required. Okay, you can directly write this. Okay.